Right, time for our traditional Friday stint in the pub now. We're going to get your opinions on our top stories.
Primetime's Tabang Motse jumped at the chance for the assignment. She's in downtown's Booze Pub Bar. It's good to see you, Tabby. What's happening where you are?
Hi, good evening, everybody, and good evening to our viewers. It's a little bit quiet here at the Booze Pub today. I think our experts are shying away from the rain, and you know what? I don't blame them. It's supposed to be spring. However, I'm not alone. I am in the presence of nobility today, so we're going to have a bit of a chat about what he thinks about what's happening in Moscow this week. So, sir, let's start off by introducing yourself. What's your name, and how long have you been in Moscow?
My name is Jacques Van Polier. I live in Russia for the last 15 years. I'm the creative director of Russia's oldest factory, the Petrodvoretz watch factory Raketa. It was founded by Peter the Great 300 years ago. And since 1962, in honor of Yuri Gagarin, they produced the watches under the brand Raketa. And I'm the designer for all these watches.
Oh, so we're talking about a history, design. I love it. The best man to ask about this question. You know, Moscow is going through a lot of urban regeneration in terms of the Golden Island. What, in terms of you being a designer in the creative industry, what do you envision for the Golden Island?
This is one of the rare areas in Moscow that really has charm. And this charm is due to many things, to this old factory, and I love factories. I work myself for a factory. And I think before changing anything, we should let it the way it is. We should try not to destroy too much. Yes, maybe we have problems with cars, but what you want? You want to build a highway on this island? That would destroy the charm of this island. So I think, first of all, we should take time and wait and think.
I agree. There is something about the Red October. The brick is so beautiful, and you know there's a lot of creative people there. Now, you touched a little bit on traffic and, you know, highways. Just this week, we actually got an announcement that from the 1st of January, that motorists are going to start, you know, paying for parking. And you know how Moscow is with traffic. What do you make of that? I mean, you're from Paris. You know, what's it like there in comparison to here?
I'm very much concerned because the first street they will test this parking is the street where I do the design of my watches. This is where I have my office, the Petrovka Street. So I, of course, not very happy I will pay this parking. And one of the things I like in Moscow is this sort of, maybe a little bit of chaos, but the sort of freedom. You park wherever you want, you don't really care, you don't have these people putting you bills everywhere, notes, and I like it. But I understand that for the traffic jam, for the future of the city, maybe we should change some things. But okay, I will be the first victim of it. I will be the first who will have to pay for his car.
Well, you won't be the only one, because officials actually are also moving buildings in terms of getting a little bit outside of the city. Because, you know, Moscow is going to be expanding twice as much by July. What do you make of that? I mean, that's going to be a big space.
This will take time. From what I read, it will be within 2 years or so that they will move these administrations outside the center. Basically, this is something that has been tried in other cities. I'm from Paris, they have also tried it. It was not always successful. I mean, the people want to stay in the center, especially the people deciding for themselves to get outside the center. The Gos Duma will have decide for themselves to get out. We will see how fast it will happen. As in a general idea, it's good to take a bit the administration out of the center so that the center is a bit more free, more for people, for activities, for museums, for cultural events. So it will maybe make the center bring more air to the center.
A little bit of a breathing space.
Yes, exactly.
So now, for the good part, what are you up to this weekend? We know you love Moscow. You've come back and forth from Paris to here. What makes Moscow so special for you?
What I love in Moscow is the energy. What I love also in Moscow, I'm here for 15 years, is there's non-stop something new, non-stop something opening, non-stop the streets are changing, the views are changing, the buildings are changing. And this is very much exciting. And with this economical boom, this youth was full of energy, this is what I love in Moscow. If you compare again with Paris, where I come from, the youth is a bit depressed because there's not so much energy in the economy. I think in Paris, the last nightclub has opened like 10 years ago, and since then they didn't open any new nightclub. So in Moscow, it's changing every day. And this makes this city so interesting for young people like us, like you, like me.
I love that. Interesting fact. So Moscow can breathe a little bit from moving some of its officials outside of the city. And parking is, you know, paying for parking is not so bad. And of course, enjoying the city for what it brings us. Lots of energy and lots to do. That's me signing off from the Booze Pub, and it's back to you in studio.
very good topic. Do you know, I think that's my favourite. That's our most intelligent and articulate guest yet, in my opinion. Thank you so much, Tubby.
Oh, I need